Hi guys, I'm Anita and I decided to do a vlog over the Borrowathon. So I'm sorry in advance if this is gonna be terrible. I didn't do very well in my vlogging last time, but I'm gonna try and attempt to do this again. The Borrowathon has started. It is about 20 minutes to 1 p.m. in Denmark right now, and so it's been going on for the last 13 hours actually, and so far I started in on Steel Heart by Brendan Sanderson. I'm not really very far. I haven't been reading a lot. I read a bit in this morning, and this is actually what I read. I read 42 pages this morning, and since then I have had breakfast, and then I have watched some YouTube videos, and then I have been doing some chores. I did some dishes and I've done some filming for next week's videos, and now I'm ready to actually read and get a lot of reading done for the day. So I'm thinking the next couple of hours I'll be reading, and then I'll probably have lunch, and then I also have to go buy some groceries for next week soon as well. Yeah, that's something I have to do as well. But other than that, I am gonna get ready to read. So yeah, I'm gonna read some more in Steel Heart, and then when I get back to you, I'll let you know what I'm feeling about it. Hi guys, this is another update for the Borrowathon. This is grainy. It's now, as you can see, it's really dark outside. So it's 8:30 p.m. What I would call 2035 an hour. Yeah, anyway. And yeah, I've been doing quite a lot of reading today. I've been reading a lot in this today. As you can see, I am now 150 pages into this. It's definitely really interesting. This is set in this world where this is sort of a futuristic world, where people with superpowers have taken over the whole world. They're evil. In this world, superheroes are villains, and they don't use their powers for any good. They're always using it for something terrible. And one day, David, who is the main character of this book, witnesses one of these people who is known as Steelheart. He witnesses him murdering his father when he's only about 5 years old or something. But he discovers something that day when he miraculously escapes from this, because he discovers that he has a weakness, and this made him obsessed about finding out the weakness about the Steelheart, so he can find a way to kill him and to sort of seek revenge on his father, but also sort of trying to save the human beings of this world from all of these super people with superpowers. And so he joins this team of rebellion. What are they called? Some sort of force. Since I'm reading this in Danish, I haven't looked up what they're called, the group is called in English, but it's sort of a special force that's taking it up as a mission to sort of trying to taking out lesser of these people with powers. They know that they have weaknesses, and they know that there are some that are easier to kill than others, but they've never gone after the really strong ones like the Steelheart. One day David tries to join that force so they can help each other with taking down the Steelheart. And this is basically what I've been reading so far. He's sort of getting into things, and I'm really enjoying it. I think it's pretty fast paced, and it definitely is interesting and not something I've been reading before. I think that the concept of all of these people with the superpowers are always evil, I think that's really interesting, and that all of the heroes are people with actually no sort of power. They only have to be smart and clever and think of other things, and that's sort of their strength in this. But I've picked up an ebook as well, so I'm reading this on my Kindle at the moment, because it's pretty dark and I don't have very great lighting in here. So in the evenings when it's a little too dark to read physical books, I tend to go switch over to my ebooks. And so now I'm reading Court of Thorns and Roses by Sarah J. Maas because I have to finish this before the 26th, so I have to read it this week. And this is a book that I have to read so I can read the shortlisted book in the BookTube SFF YA category awards. So far, it's okay, it's nothing amazing, but I have heard that everyone thinks that the second book is 10 times better than the first, so I am hoping that will be true. And it is pretty fast paced, I guess. I have read 106 pages of the ebook, and I started out when I was 30 or 40 pages in, so I've been reading about 60 pages of that one as well. And so yeah, I'm pretty happy with my progress so far today, and this will be my final update for today, but this has definitely been an interesting first day, and I've been joining in on some sprints, so that has been fun. And hopefully I'll also be able to join in on some sprints tomorrow if it fits with my time zone and after I've gotten home from work and all of that. I'm not going to be able to join in on the late sprint because it'll be starting at 1 a.m. in my time zone. And I have work, obviously, so I have to get up at 6, so that's not gonna happen. But I'll see you later or tomorrow with a new update, and yeah, goodbye.
Hello everyone, it's day 2 of Borrowathon, and so far I haven't been reading a lot today. I'm on page 200 of Steelheart by Brendan Sanderson. It is now 7:30 p.m. and since I've gotten home I've read like 30 pages or something. But I finished dinner, so I don't have a lot of things to do still. So now I have a couple of hours at least of reading. Hopefully I'll stay alert so I can read a lot. But we'll see how it goes. I want to get a little further into this one. I'm over halfway with this one now, just over. And yeah, it's still pretty intriguing and things are definitely happening and I'm enjoying it, so we'll see. Usually I also listen to audios over readathons. I am listening to an audio, but it's not exactly one I've been borrowing, but it's not one I own either, so it's sort of a gray zone, I feel like. And I'm not gonna count it because I know I won't be able to finish it anyway. I still have about 14 hours left, and I've listened to about 6 hours now, and I listen to about an hour every day. And if you're curious about the book that I'm talking about, it is The Golden Fool by Robin Hobb, the second book in the Tawny Man trilogy, and I really enjoyed the first book, and this is definitely also starting to become interesting. It's very slow moving. Robin Hobb's books tend to be really slow paced and just focusing on a lot of characters, and that's actually something I like to listen to when I'm driving. I can just sit there and relax and yeah, listen to this audio, and so I'm enjoying it. So that's what I've been reading today. So I'm not gonna count the audio in, but I'm gonna count the 30 pages that I read in Steelheart. I actually think I read something this morning as well. I think I was on about page 150 or something when I went to bed of this book, so I'll say I read up till 181. So actually I've only read 19 pages since I got home, and then before that I read about 30 pages this morning, so about 50 pages I've gotten through so far. So that's my progress for the day. We'll see how I'm doing by the end of the day. But yeah, this was an update for now. I'm talking way too much, I'm sorry. Hi guys. It's day 3 of the readathon. I haven't really read very much today. It's 7:45 p.m. So 7:45. I haven't read more in this. Well, I did read some more last night, but since then I haven't. I'm on page 258.
So I have about a little more than 100 pages left. I'm not sure how much I'm going to get read today. I wanted to finish this, but I have a headache that's sneaking up on me, like a migraine sort of headache. This is something I've been dealing with for the last, I don't know how many years, that I've randomly get these headaches. I think I've said this before, but it's not like my doctor has said that this is migraines. It could be like tension headaches, like from because I'm sitting wrong and other sort of things, like stress related and stuff. But yeah, it's definitely something that has completely ruined some days for me, in terms of work and just about everything. And right now it's getting worse. I haven't actually had one in a couple of months now, so I was hoping, because I've been eating a lot differently for the past month and a half, well, at least for the past month. I've started on a new diet. I had a lot of headaches then, but that was because of my lack of sugar intake, and that sort of gave me headaches because that's the norm, and I knew that I would get that because of that. But I got over that after a couple of days, and I haven't had anything since then. And so I thought that maybe this had helped, because I'm drinking a lot more water now, so I get a lot more fluids through me, and by that not dehydrating and stuff. But it's definitely something that's still affecting me, apparently. And if you're wondering what diet I'm on, I started on the LCHF diet. I don't know if it's something I will stick to, but I wanted to give it a shot, because I think if I'm gonna stick to a diet, that is the closest I'll get to it, because I think the things that I have to leave out is not as terrible as some others. And it's not like I want to have this like a permanent diet. I want to have like specifics of this like taken into like a sort of lifestyle change, but I still want to be able to sort of eat whatever I want sometimes, just more moderately, so that I don't eat too much of these unhealthy things. And it's been going pretty well. I've been able to sleep better at night. I sleep for all night through without waking up, and I didn't do that before. I always had like one or two times at night I woke up for whatever reason. I still want cake and sweets and stuff pretty much all the time. But it's easier to stay away from, because I'm not hungry all the time, because that this diet, even though I only eat three times a day, they keep me satiated for a lot of hours at the time. And so that's actually really nice, that I don't really think too much about I need this and this and this. This was a long update, I'm sorry, and if I'm rambling too much, I'm sorry about that as well. And if this is something that you don't care at all about, I'm also sorry about that. But I don't have a lot of bookish updates today, so I just thought I'll let you know about this. So there's that. I'll probably not update until tomorrow again, so bye. Hi, it's day 5 of the readathon. It's Thursday. I didn't do an update yesterday. I didn't feel really good. My nose is really red. I had a major headache, and so I didn't read a lot either. But I did manage to finish. I only had about 20 pages or something left of Steelheart by Brendan Sanderson, the first book in the Reckoners trilogy. And I ended up really, really enjoying it. I really thought that Brendan Sanderson was writing this in a really great way. There was a lot of, I think the plot was interesting, and there were a lot of interesting characters, and then there were some plot twists at times that I didn't see coming, and I really enjoyed that. And then the only other book that I've read by Brendan Sanderson is The Final Empire, which is the first book in the Mistborn series. And I thought it was quite fun to see how different his writing style was in that compared to this one, and how he sort of transitioned himself
to the YA genre and in this sort of futuristic setting. That was really interesting to see, yet still he has his own sort of style and I like that. I think I'm ending up on a 4.5 out of 5 stars. It was really close to a 5-star read for me, so really, really great first book for the readathon. I actually also, because of me not feeling really well yesterday, I didn't want to pick up another book, but I did pick up my graphic novel, and that is The Walking Dead Volume 1, and I finished that in about an hour or something. I really, really enjoyed it. It was really, really good, and yeah, it was just really amazing. It's quite interesting that the art style, the art is black and white all the way through. I've never read, except for manga, I haven't read anything that's just pure black and white all the way through. But I didn't mind it. I actually didn't really think about that a lot. I thought that the graphic was pretty detailed anyway, and I think that maybe it would have been a little too... I don't know, I think it worked well in black and white. And the storyline was really, really amazing. It was a lot more about these characters and finding out about them rather than just zombies all over eating everyone, and I enjoyed it. And if this is how the TV show is like, then I definitely understand why it's so popular. And I'm gonna read the next many volumes, as many as there are at our library. I don't know how many they have, and I ended up giving it a 5 out of 5 stars because I couldn't give it less. I was really blown away by it, actually. So that was really nice. And then today, since I've been feeling a lot better, I have started in on Sapphire Blue. I've only just started it, and I'm only about 40 pages in, 2 chapters and a prologue. But yeah, it's a pretty easy read so far, and it's pretty much just starting up where the last book ended, and so I'm interested in seeing where this is gonna go. I've also been reading, this morning I read something in A Court of Thorns and Roses. I still think it's a little meh. Yeah, there are some moments that are okay, but overall the characters just doesn't really grab me. But yeah, this was an update for now, and I'll see you later. Hello. It's now Saturday evening, day 7 of Borrowathon. I haven't been reading a lot both yesterday and today. Yesterday was my mother's birthday, so after work we went straight to my parents' house, and I did bring my iPad so that I could probably get a few more pages in from A Court of Thorns and Roses, which I have been working on. I have to have it finished tomorrow, as it expires. As you can see, I have these two down on my library account, and this expires tomorrow. And then I have to read furthermore after that. I have 8 days to read that, so I can start it maybe tomorrow when I finish this one. We'll see. I've read about half of the book today, I think. No, between yesterday and today I've read half of the Court of Thorns and Roses. I think I was at 33% when I started reading it yesterday, and now I am on page... about 500, I think, of 612. I thought I'd be able to finish this today, but I'm extremely tired right now. I'm really having a hard time staying awake. Yesterday, after we were celebrating my mother's birthday yesterday evening, and afterwards I went to my sister's house to stay over there. I did read a bit before bed there, and then I went to bed at like 1 a.m. or something. I think I stopped reading at about that time, and I am terrible at sleeping in, and especially when I'm not in my own bed as well. So I ended up waking up at 6:30 because I'm weird like that, and
So that means I've only had 5.5 hours sleep last night, and I did get a nap earlier when I got home because I was so tired, but I didn't sleep for very long. But yeah, the reason I stayed over at my sister's is because that she had a brunch today, because it's her and my other sister's birthday tomorrow. So I had to help her getting ready for that, and also as part of the party thing, brunch, birthday party thing. So I can't wait to finish this book and maybe check out something else tomorrow. So we'll see what I'm in the mood for then. I do have a couple of hours to read tomorrow because I'm not going to be at my sister's house until 6 p.m. And obviously my sisters are twins, so if you didn't know that, now you know. And so we're going to celebrate their birthday tomorrow evening with my brother, my mom and dad, my brother, and both of my sister's boyfriends. So we're going to be 8 people. Tomorrow's the last day of Borrowathon. This week has gone really, really fast. We'll see how I'm doing tomorrow. Right now, I want to sleep.
Hi guys, I am back with another update. It's the last day of Borrowathon for this round, and I finished A Court of Thorns and Roses today. Finally. And it is expired for my account. I just barely managed to finish it before it expired. I thought I had all day actually, but I finished it this morning, and then when I opened up the overdraft account later, it was expired. So that was really lucky. But I ended up giving it a 3 stars because I didn't hate it, but I also didn't love it. I had some issues with the main character, Fair, and I didn't really get by with the romance. But I did think that the last part of the book, I think the last 100 pages, 150 pages or so of the book, were really interesting. So that was good. I have since not read much, and I don't have very long yet still to read because I have to go to my sister's birthday later today. I'm gonna be there at 6 p.m. and it's now 1:42 p.m. But I do have a couple of hours left of reading before I have to get ready for that. And I thought I could go to read Sci-Fi Blue and finish that maybe. But I really don't feel like reading it because I kind of think that the main character is a pushover right now. And the love interest is a dick. He's really annoying. And then all of these people who are part of this time travel group of people are very chauvinistic. And I really hate that at the moment. So I don't want to feel like reading that book right now. I probably will finish it because I want to tick off this series, and I do like the sort of time traveling system, you know, how it works and all of that, and I am kind of interested in seeing where this series will progress, but I really can't get by the romance, and I can't get by, and I think that the main character is annoying, and she's just forgiving the love interest, just even though he's been really horrible to her. She just, oh yeah, but if he just does this, then I might forgive him again. And I'm like, why? Why would you forgive him for that? It's like, really hate it. So the book that I'm planning on trying to finish, hopefully, is the third book in the Discworld series by Terry Pratchett. This is the first book in the Witches series, and it's called Equal Rights, and in Danish, it's called The Eighth Daughter, just if you wanted to know. But I'm definitely, this is a really short book, so I might be able to finish it actually. And they should be pretty fun, so I hope I'll be able to finish this, but I'll give you an update tonight when I've gotten home from the birthday.
Hi, this is the final update for Borrowathon for this round. I didn't manage to get very far with Equal Rights, but I did manage to read the first 50 pages of the book. It's quite funny. He definitely knows how to write some interesting plot lines. But what I found really strange, what I find really strange about this book, it doesn't have any chapters, so it just keeps on going for on and on. It doesn't have any chapter breaks. It does have like breaks like these, you know, not breaks in between paragraphs, but it is quite funny. It starts with this man who is the eighth son, and he has seven sons and is just about to have his eighth son. And then a some magician comes to say that the eighth son will have magic, will be a wizard. But it turns out that the eighth son is actually not a son, but a daughter. So that the daughter is a wizard. And that is not something that they're happy with, because that cat, because there's this witch who's like, women can't be wizards, they can only be witches, and wizards can't be witches, just the same with the other sex. But I thought that was pretty funny, and it's definitely interesting already, and I've always had some laugh out loud moments. So I'm really looking forward to finishing it. But I've had a lot of fun participating in the Borrowathon, and I'd like to thank all of the hosts for the wonderful week. It's been really fun, and I've participated in sprints as often as I could. Sometimes the sprints were while I was at work or while I was sleeping. But at all the times that I was able to join in, I did as much as I could. Yeah, but I can't wait to participate in Borrowathon again. I just saw that there will be a Borrowathon again in November, so I'm really looking forward to that. But I'm happy I did manage to finish 3 books. Not the best I could do. I'm not sure about the exact page count for the week, but I will add, if I can figure that out, I'll add it up here. So you can see how many pages I actually did read. It was a busy week, especially the weekends here with all of the birthdays. This was my update, my last and final update. I'm rambling. I hope this video won't be too long, and if it is, I'm sorry. I'm terrible at vlogging. But, bye.